Hey everybody, today we are having an unboxing and a review, so let's get started. See how that's on there. I don't know if I'm on it. There we go. Yeah. See here. After some minor surgery, we got in there because our friend John packed it so well, and the box was really well put together, taped together. Looks like plenty of padding and cushioning in there. There's what was in the box. Looks to be an old Yamaha case, but it is not a Yamaha on the inside. This is a 1974 Boosey & Hawkes Imperial E-flat bass, 4-valve compensating. You can see it's in really nice shape for its age. I want to thank my friend and yours, John Sefton Powell, over in the UK, who is a highly accomplished brass musician, and he comes across nice brass instruments, works on them, puts them up for sale. And thanks, John. It came very quickly. I was really surprised, but anxious to try the instrument. Now let's see what the backside looks like. Here's the backside. And it has the old ball down on the keel. That should tell you about the vintage of this instrument. Carry ring. We are ready for brass banding. Let's check it out and see what it sounds like. Thank you. I've always wanted to try a Boosian Hawks Imperial E-flat. They were the standard E-flat for decades in the UK and the banding world. And of course, Bessin, their 981 and some of their other models, they've been around, but the Imperial has a bit of status. I don't know that anybody uses them with the frequency that maybe they once did. I think the 19-inch Bell 981 or that style of E-flat is what's most common. But these are still around, and you can pick one up used if you're careful or you pay attention and find one that's in good playing condition, good mechanical condition. And this one is. No, it's not brand new. It's almost 50 years old. And so there's little dings here. There's little repair work here and there. You know, the valves are not brand new and pristine. They're not awful. They work, and that's what's important. So it's a fun instrument to play. I haven't adjusted any of the slides. I've just oiled the thing and started to play. So you're hearing whatever intonation it is as it is. I haven't made any adjustments. And I think the intonation is pretty darn good. It's respectable. It's manageable. There aren't any wonky notes. Response is pretty good from top to bottom. So no problem there. It is a joy to play it. And it has that smaller bell, clearer singing sound, but it has kind of a euphonium kind of a quality. There's a roundness to it. It kind of has its own mojo. And speaking of that, with the mouthpiece, now John sent a Dennis Wick 3 with the appropriate shank. He says that that's pretty much the go-to or one of the standard mouthpieces that folks over there use with the Imperial E-flat.
So he included one, and I've tried it with my other mouthpieces. Of course, I hardly have any proper British style small shanks, but even the other ones, just to get an idea of what the tone would sound like. The Dennis Wick has the sound. It helps bring out that kind of I'm just going to say it's like a the horn's own mojo. It brings it out. And the other mouthpieces, not so much. Now with the Wick mouthpiece, low range is a little tighter. You're just going to have to get used to that. And that's okay. You know, I like things to be pretty wide open down below. But, you know, this tuba, you know, it's, what am I going to play it for? Not much down low. It still has a good low range. It's accessible, but it's, you know, it's just not wide open. So, and that's okay. And I didn't expect it to be, but you can certainly play it down there without much trouble. There'd be some adjusting on my part, because as John said, and, you know, he and I were talking, and Richard Fox, if you don't know Richard, I'll put his information down below too, along with John's. Richard is a super tuba player over in the UK. He does all kinds of music. Some of the funky bass lines and the, you just got to check his stuff. Oh, we're talking about mouthpieces, and we're all on the kind of the same page. You know, they had some helpful information, but you know, if you, I got to have a low range, I got to have it wide open, well, you might sacrifice something else. And with some of these other mouthpieces, that tone, that mojo, that certain kind of sound, I'm going to have to sacrifice, and that's not worth it. So the Dennis Wick 3, if that's the go-to mouthpiece over there, or it's one of the standards that they use, I get it. There's just something that works. Whatever that is, don't know, don't care. I'm going to plug it in, we're going to play it, and we're going to have a good time making music with it. So I want to give another shout out to John Powell. It was my pleasure to do business with you, and I hope we can again in the future. I'll be talking to you on the interwebs. And hey, Richard Fox, thank you for your information. It's good to touch base with you. And check these guys out. I'll have all their information down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe here as well. Share with your friends. If you want to see some cool videos, check these out. We'll see you next time.